Would you like to learn the real cloud architect job description? Would you like to know the real cloud architect skills and why it's so hard to get hired as a cloud architect, even though there's a sea of people out there with cloud certifications? Well, I'm going to tell you this. If you have the skills that we're going to talk about in this video, it'll be easy to get any cloud architect job you want. The reason it's so hard to hire cloud architects is there's a mismatch between people and what they learn versus what they need to be learning to become a cloud architect. And it's because often people confuse the cloud engineering role, which is a building role, with the cloud architecture role, which is a design and planning role. So in this video, we're going to talk about what we do as cloud architects, the exact real cloud architect job description. I'm going to break this video down into the two elements of our job. The first element is going to be on the tech side or the design side. The second side is going to be the business side. Now, it's going to be really hard to differentiate in certain cases whether these are tech or business skills, but I kind of classified them the best we potentially could. So we'll begin with the tech or the design skills. As architects, we don't touch the technology. We don't code. We don't configure. We don't do Terraform. We don't touch Linux, but we have to design systems for our clients. So let's talk about these design things. One of the main things we do as architects is we create a technology roadmap, and it's the types of technologies that we may use to optimize our clients' business performance. And a lot of that planning goes into that. For example, we have to analyze the current IT systems and the current infrastructure that we have. We have to identify areas for improvement in both the IT systems as well as the processes that are used in that organization. These are business processes like how is a product made, for example, or how is a product serviced. Now, we have to create what's called a future state architecture model. And what is that? So here's what they have today. Here's where they want to be in the future. That's that future state. Now, as architects, we're always looking for various technologies that could optimize our clients' business performance. So we're going to be constantly evaluating any type of emerging technology. And would this emerging technology help our clients in their business? Now, we will do what's called a lot of gap analysis. So one of the main gap analyses that we will perform is, you know, here are the systems today. Here's the systems we need for the future. What's the difference or the gap or the delta between them? And that's a gap analysis we're going to be creating all the time. Now, as architects, we're going to provide technical guidance. Now, it's going to be strategic guidance, not how to build something, because that's done and relegated by the engineers. We will oversee system integration efforts. So a cloud architect, if we work for an enterprise, there may be 200 to 1,000 different applications. And obviously, we're not application architects. We're not application developers. We're cloud architects. But the point is they're going to have all these integration points. So we're going to have to coordinate with application developers, coordinate with application architects, and coordinate with a lot of vendors along the way. Now, we have to design scalable and flexible IT solutions. What does that mean? It means the technology must be able to expand, contract, work with the business. If the business grows, be able to handle the business. So, you know, that type of thing is what we're dealing with a lot. Now, we're going to have to evaluate and select the best technology platforms our clients need. There's no such thing as the best technology, but what is the best technology for our clients need? Maybe we have a tremendous number of transactions and we want to use a mainframe. Maybe we need ultimate agility and scalability and we want to go to the public cloud. Maybe we've got a high performance workload and guess what? It's going to be cheapest to run in that data center or that private cloud. So that's what we're talking about here. We will routinely conduct technology audits where we'll bring people in and they'll start evaluating the technology to see the technology's performance, utilization, capacity, what have you. We will constantly be overseeing cloud migration strategies. What are we going to move? What should we move? How do we move it? Do we have one big architecture? Do we have transitional architectures along the way? And that kind of planning is big in what we do. We may be involved in developing what's called a reference architecture for common use cases. So maybe we've got a business conglomerate and they have multiple divisions and we can create a common architecture platform that if you're going to design this, this is how you do it. Sometimes that's appropriate based upon the business needs. We will always be managing IT portfolios and prioritizing investments. Let's face it, there's only going to be a limited amount of money or financial resources available to the client. So we're going to have to determine what's going to give them the biggest impact for their business and help them prioritize where they're going to spend their money. We will also be doing a lot of architecture and maturity assessments. Where are they now? How sophisticated are they? What could they potentially do? We will always be looking at means to ensure interoperability between systems. What type of systems do we need? How do we get them to talk to each other? We're often developing enterprise-wide security architectures, working with the security team and the legal team and the compliance team from that business. We're always looking for ways to get rid of technical debt and get rid of legacy systems that are going to cost too much to run. We will typically do some cloud architecture impact assessments to try to see, okay, if we make these changes, how is that going to affect the business? And we may be doing that from a change management perspective, or we may be doing it from a new architecture perspective. We may be looking and working with application teams to develop API strategies and governance of various APIs. We may be looking at an organization's data warehouse and business intelligence initiatives. We're going to be working on the organization's mobile and digital strategies. And typically, we're going to develop and maintain enterprise integration patterns and potentially even conduct architecture health check. What's working, what's not working. Now, there are the more technical things that we do. And obviously, there's part business as well. Now, let's talk about the leadership and business things we do as architects. Well, we're constantly working with key stakeholders and the leadership to develop IT governance policies and procedures. We're constantly collaborating with stakeholders to understand business needs, taking an architecture, presenting it back to the stakeholders, and getting their feedback. Our main job as architects is to optimize our clients' business performance, and that's about aligning the IT initiatives with the overall business strategy. You may hear it talked about as people, processes, and technology, but that's the alignment that we're working for. We will develop and enforce architecture standards and best practices. We will be involved with assessing various risks, including IT risks and how we potentially might mitigate these risks. We will be looking to optimize our IT resource allocation. We will create architecture review boards. So anytime there's a proposed change, for example, the review board can say if this is going to work and how it works in the context of that business. We do a lot of meeting facilitation and facilitating communication between the IT teams and the business teams. In some ways, we're more of a liaison than anything else. We do a lot of managing of vendor relationships for our various IT systems. We're constantly involved in developing disaster recovery and business continuity plans. We're always working with the legal and governance team to ensure compliance with industry regulations and standards. We may mentor and develop junior architects, and I know I've done a lot of that in my architecture career. We will definitely participate and in many cases lead and facilitate strategic planning sessions. We will have to determine what are the key metrics to measure the architecture's effectiveness. For example, if we've got a client that's global retail and they're trying to increase their sales, what is the impact on sales of our new architecture? We will be constantly managing stakeholders and their expectations. Obtaining stakeholder buy-in to make sure that our architectures are successful. We'll manage a lot of architecture documentation. We may even develop and maintain architecture frameworks. So these are the main things we do as cloud architects. We do these same things as enterprise architects as well. Now, the reason it's so hard to hire people as cloud architects, the reason we have such a massive cloud architect shortage, and these jobs are yours for the taking and they pay well because there's a huge demand and no supply, is that people are learning things like a certification, the name of a service, and how to configure that. And we don't touch technology as architects. They're learning DevOps. They're learning SysOps. They're learning to code. And these are all wonderful skills for other people's careers. But if you want to be a cloud architect, the 50 or so things that we talked about in this video, this is what we do with cloud architects. These are those cloud architect skills. This is the real cloud architect job description. Master these things and you will have an incredible cloud architect career or enterprise architect career. If you desire to be a cloud architect, come join us on one of our free webinars or download one of our free cloud architecture ebooks. There's a link to this ebook and free webinar in the description of this video. And join the webinar. It'll be on Zoom. We'll talk about what we do, how we do it, all the skills you need. And it's on Zoom, so you can ask questions and we'll do anything we can to help you in your technology career on these free Zoom sessions. Also, there's lots of free ebooks in the description of this video. Books on what we do as cloud architects, enterprise architects, AI architects, how to win the interview, all kinds of great things. And they're all free, so download them. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your technology career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now. I look forward to seeing you in a new video or a new webinar. Take care.